Welcome back to The Price of Business. I'm your host, Kevin Price, talking to you about you and your business. Wonder if you got a bad picker. That's I love the title of this book. That's what we're going to talk about here on today's program. It's going to be the power of your mind when it comes to relationship development and even how you look at yourself. And our guest today, Dr. Jesse Carr, MD, is going to talk about it. I think this is going to be a very timely and even entertaining topic. And Dr. Carr, welcome to the program.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
Tell us a little bit about your background. I see you're in psychiatry, just to let the listener know from an MD perspective, which would obviously make you gravitate towards a topic like this book-wise. But tell us a little bit about the background.
Yes, I'm a psychiatrist. I've been practicing psychiatry for 24 years. And I've been the medical director for several programs. And when I started thinking about the book, I was working as a medical director for the Elbridge program. So it's a senior program. And I was noticing that a lot of women, a lot of senior women, were looking back in their life and they had a lot of regret. And I was surprised. Like, why would they have so much regret? They should be looking back in their lives and feeling a sense of satisfaction of their family or their relationships. But a lot of people had a lot of regret about, you know, the relationships they've been in, about the husbands they may have stayed with or the choices they didn't make. And so then I started paying more attention, you know, as the years went on. So that's kind of the impetus of my background and why I was kind of writing the book.
Okay. And what did you find? What are the reasons behind this dissatisfaction?
I think there are lots of potential causes. I think we can tend to make choices more emotionally or what society or what our family thinks we should choose. Sometimes we kind of just go through the motions. Oftentimes women choose the bad boy or the alpha male, or sometimes we choose, you know, people with poor character, not realizing sometimes we get into this pattern of just choosing the wrong guy, and you kind of get on this merry-go-round, and it's hard to get off.
Yeah, I can see that, and I guess a lot of this points back to family of origin issues, right?
Yeah, I think there's lots of underlying causes. You know, sometimes, you know, you may have had an absent father, and you're looking to kind of replace him in your current relationship. You know, you may be repeating old drama, you know, over and over again, but getting kind of the same results, and so people end up with this feeling of regret or loss or missed opportunity.
Yeah, and there's probably a lot of familiarity with an unhealthy, you know, choice in your unhealthy choices. This looks like dad, this looks like mom, or whatever that type of deal is. Reality is you didn't like dad or mom.
Yeah.
So why are you doing that? I mean, there's a lot of that, you know, I think in the decision-making process. So what is your objective? What was your objective in writing the book? Obviously, it couldn't have been just merely awareness, because as you're pointing out, most of these people are already pretty unhappy with what they've got. So what was your thoughts behind it?
Well, really, I mean, on one level, this book is about, you know, relationships and, like, the causes and consequences of making poor choices in relationships, and then how to improve your ability to choose a good partner, improve your picking ability. But there's on a second level, it's really about how to live life without regret, you know, and how to make the best choices for your happiness at each stage, at every chance that you get, making the best choice. You know, living life in the moment, you know, learning to savor life, you know, finding a way to merge your talents and your passions for your happiness, you know, building your self-confidence. When you're confident, you know, you're more likely to make a better choice. When you're happier, you make better choices in life. And then when you savor your life, you tend to live life without regret. So that's really what the book is about, is how to live life without regret.
Okay. And so obviously the younger you are when you get this, the better. But the reality is that people want, you know, if you figure it out at 50, if you figure it out at 15, whatever, figure it out.
Yes, it's never too late. It's never too late to make a change and to save your life and to make a choice for your own happiness. It's never too late for that. And this book is good for both men and women, so it's not just for women and bad relationships or dissatisfied with the relationships, but there's a holistic kind of approach with multiple strategies, kind of new kind of strategies, you know, to help you enhance your picking ability, enhancing your ability to live life to the fullest.
So let me ask you, how big of a role, or how big of a focus is on the relationship aspects of self versus other areas when it comes to being happy in the book?
I think you have to be happy first, you know, and you have to be, enhance your own self-esteem and your own self-awareness first, you know, kind of with, as I always say, you know, you have to leave your bags at the door when you're coming into a relationship. So the relationship comes second. So making good decisions for your own happiness, your own well-being, then you're better able to participate and have a full and quality relationship.
Yeah.
And so the book is probably half about relationships and half about self-improvement.
You know, and it's almost cliche-ish, you know, I hate to say it, but, you know, when I look at the situation, you know, we've heard the language, to quote the old Who song, one and one doesn't equal two, one and one equals one. But what's required, you know, in that whole deal is two whole individuals going into a relationship, not a half looking for a half, because that makes the other person way more important and means you're bringing a lot less to that relationship. Don't you agree?
Yeah, that is so true. You definitely have to focus on yourself and make it the most. And if you're happy and if you're living your life fully, you know, to the fullest, if you're using your talents and you're living kind of an enriched life, then you're better able to enter into a relationship and the happiness, you know, quotient will go way up.
Yeah, no question about it. No question about it. So when did the book come out?
The book is out, so you can get the book on Amazon.com or BarnesandNoble.com, and you just type in Got a Bad Picker, and it'll pop up. There's an e-book, and you can also order a paperback copy.
When did it get released?
It got released in May.
Oh, wow, so it's brand new.
Yeah, it's brand new. It's just out, and I'm really excited about it. I think there's a lot of fun, fun quotes in there from different people, and lots of things that I've learned over the years of practice. You know, so I've run a number of programs, I've seen thousands of patients, and so I've kind of put together the best things that I've learned over, and I kind of just put it into like a how-to book. And so there's a lot of practical strategies and that people can use in their everyday life.
Yeah, very cool. I think it sounds extremely timely and important, and I really encourage people to check it out. Simply put in Got a Bad Picker, and put that in the Google search. And actually, if you go to Amazon, it'd be even quicker. And
exactly.
It's by Jesse Carr, MD. And is this your first book?
This is my first book. But I'm working on the second book called Got a Bad Picker for the Men. you know how that is.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. Yeah. There you go. Yeah. You know, you actually made my producer turn extremely red. So you can imagine how I'm looking. But, you know, that is the reality. And it seems like the younger they are, the more likely they are to do that. And, you know, there needs to be a lot more brought into a relationship other than chemistry.
Exactly.
And
exactly.
So that's interesting. So currently, are you actually tactically working with patients today?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm a practicing psychiatrist, researcher. I conduct a lot of research studies, working in a number of programs. So, yeah, I'm actively, trying out. These are tried and true strategies. I draw a lot from positive psychology, which is kind of different than the usual psychologies, which are like you're having some kind of illness, but it's really about, you know, making the most of your life, going toward more of the happiness model or the wellness model as opposed to a model of pathology.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, it's very interesting, and, I'm actively seeing patients.
Dr. Jesse Carr, check out his book, and Got a Bad Picker, and I encourage you to learn more about it. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you so much.
All right, when we come back, much more for you. I do want to remind you, best content here shows up over there at usdailyreview.com, and you're listening to The Price of Business.